Hello guys, welcome back to another video. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can make a simple poster in really easier way. So all of you guys normally present in the lab seminars or also present in the meetings that you frequently have in the week or you normally have in the month. So once you make a presentation, or once you are doing or making a results report, you can make your presentation as good as you want. The more good the presentation is, the more easier it's for you when you're making a poster. So right now I spend a lot of time on these presentations so that I can make one single presentation good enough so that I can also use it later on when I'm working for the poster. So now I made each section and each slide differently so that I can use this data or these graphs and all that infographics for my presentation. Remember one thing. A good poster is the one which has more infographics and less text, because people don't want to watch the text again and again, because they want to watch some infographics and some graphs and some bar charts or some other things that looks that can catch their attraction or that is a bit different from the ones others are presenting. So these are the graphs that I typically make in Microsoft PowerPoint and Excel, and sometimes I make use of Origin Pro. So but in your case, you can also make attractive graphs in simply Microsoft Excel. So let's go and start, and we are going to start by doing another slide. But before that, let me show you what is the slide orientation and the slide size for this poster. So normally the poster size is A0, which is 33 inches by 46.8 inches. So normally the size is recommended by the conferences, but A0 is the normal size which is being used for the posters. So now let's just remove this layout, and after removing the layout, the first thing is that we are going to add a main heading. Normally I just go with a bold heading. That means that I want to have a dark background for my heading and a simple and light text inside the heading. So this is my main heading, and followed by with my name and then my affiliation. So normally I tend to have a dark background for my title slide so that I can have it more visible in comparison to the rest of my slide. So the reason why I do it is that I want to catch the interaction towards the title of my slide, and then later on goes towards my below part, which is the results and all the sections. So now you can see that I'm giving different colors for the title and different color for the name and the university. So the title comes first and the name and then the university. Let's just save time, and I'm going to copy the same thing from here. The text that I use is sample text, so I'm just using a simple font, which is Calibri font, and you can also see that this font is easily available in Microsoft PowerPoint. So now the thing that I'm going to show is that you are going to simply divide your poster into two parts. So make sure that the length and the height of your slides are equal to the width of this each rectangle that I showed you now. So now I'm just going to show you a simple example. Now these are my slide contents. I'm going to copy them and paste them as a picture here. So now you can see that once I paste them here, they are exactly without a background and they're transparent images. So I'm going to increase it to 16.8 so that the width is as equal as the half. So now you can see that if I adjust the size a little bit more, I can adjust two slides easily on this poster. So now one slide is done. So let's go to the second slide, copy the contents again, copy them, and then simply paste them as a picture. Okay. Once you paste them as a picture, you can increase the size and make it equal to the one shown above. So these are the bar graphs, or these are the charts that I made simply in Microsoft Excel, not in Origin Pro. And then later on, I just use helping text to explain each bar which I want to show. So you can easily make this in Microsoft PowerPoint, and it's really easy and convenient to do. If you want, you can check my different videos in this post, and I will leave a link in the description so that you can easily watch my previous videos on these graphics. Now I'm going to repeat the same step for the other slides also, but just to save time, I'm going to paste this one now, and then later I'm going to repeat the same step for the other, and I'm just going to show you the final version by just simply copying from my previous sample slide that I showed you before. So this is just as easy as you want. So the main goal of your weekly and monthly presentation is that once you make it, when you are spending time, it's recommended that you spend enough time that you make it good enough so that when your conference comes, you don't have to spend enough time. Rather than, you can spend more time on practicing what you are going to show and what you're going to present. So this is how you make a simple poster by using the slide contents from your presentations, and you can simply use them as a picture and you can arrange them accordingly. So you can see that I simply arranged the slide contents like this, and it didn't take me more than 5 to 10 minutes to make this poster. Now let's just work on the background, what we can do with these backgrounds. So for example, I'm going to show you some different examples what you can do. So remember, if you are choosing a dark color for the background, It's not recommended to use dark colors. So when you're using solid fills, it's recommended to use the upper layer of the colors, because these are the lighter tones and these will help make your text more vibrant. But if you're using a dark color, make sure that you use a dark font so that they can be more prominent on your color, on your poster. So now you can see that these do look good, but they are not too visible when you're presenting in a live session. So I recommend you to use light colors. So now you have different options and different variations. One of the variations is the most common one is a gradient variation. They are presets defined. You can simply use them from the preset gradients and you can use different colors. So you see, once I use a different color, it looks too beautiful and too different and completely changes the image of the poster. So this is how you can make a simple poster in just a matter of 5 minutes. It won't take you long time, won't take you much of time, but provided that when you are presenting in your weekly meetings or your monthly seminars, it is recommended that you spend enough time to make good and attractive graphics to explain your content in a beautiful way, so that when it comes to present for a conference, you don't have to spend enough time, you don't have to spend more time to make your poster. Rather, you just have to copy the slides and just have to paste in that poster. So now you can see that I'm just changing different colors, and with every different color you can see the poster is getting more and more beautiful, and also it's giving a different image. So one idea or tip is that you can simply change the gradient of your poster, and when you present it to somewhere else, it will look like a simple different poster as you made from a screen. So that's all for today's video. I'm going to add the link for my previous poster videos in this group, and you can find the link in the description, and you can find and see if those kind of posters help you a bit more, or it gives you a different idea how you can make us assign abstract posters in a simple and easier ways. Also, if you want to know how to make these bar charts or pie charts in the Microsoft PowerPoint, I will also leave a link for those videos so that you can watch them and you can learn, and for the next presentation you can make more interesting and good looking abstracts. I hope you like this video. If you haven't watched my previous video, do watch them, and if you haven't subscribed, do subscribe them. Till then, take care. Allah Hafiz.